Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. I am Om and today we are going to learn how to prepare a structural drawing. So let's have a look at our structural drawing. Let me share my screen with you. So this is how our structural drawing looks like. I have already discussed this drawing with you in my previous video. For that, you can click on the I link, like I button. And now, so this was our structural drawing. This is our plinth beam layout, and today we will learn how to make this plinth beam layout. But before drawing that plinth beam layout, we need to understand how to make the table for that. Like this is our table for plinth beam. Let me show you. Yeah, this is our schedule of plinth beam. In this you can see beam marked, size, what kind of reinforcement is there, continuous, extra reinforcement or shear. Even in the continuous, how much bars will be present at the top and bottom, and in extra reinforcement, number of bars and the size of bars will be mentioned at the start, end and in center. Even in the shear reinforcement, we will know what is there at support and center. So how do we prepare this? So first of all, I have designed a model, a building model in a STAT Pro. You can see all those classes by clicking on the I button, which will be showing here. And after that, once you complete designing part in a STAT Pro, you can come back and learn this table, like how to make the schedule of plinth beam. So let's go to our STAT Pro. I have already made a model here. Everything related to this model is available on our channel. You can visit it. So this was our 3D model. You can see it. Let's have a 3D look. So here, this was our 3D model of our building. This is how it looks like. This was our headroom, and the rest are already described in our previous videos. So we will go to the front view and select the plinth beam. Go to view and then view selected objects only. After that, we will go to the top view. I may be fast over here, but I have explained these things in a very smooth way in my previous videos, so you can learn it from there. Now, once we are done at our plinth beam, so we can take a screenshot. Every laptop has a different way of taking a screenshot. You can use that, or if you are using Windows, you can use your sniping tool. Okay, so in this, take new and save this image. Save. Let's name it plinth beam. I will save it on my desktop. So here is how it looks like. Now we need to name all these beams. So the question was, how we reached here? For that, we have completed the designing of a model in a STAT Pro. Now, once the designing was complete, we took the screenshot of plinth beam. Now we need to name these beams. So you can write the steps so that you don't have to face difficulty in future. Now we will name it as PB1, PB2, PB3 and so on. For that, I've already named it. So I will just open it for you. You can also suggest us if you have any suggestion regarding our online classes. So how much informative this all these videos are for you. You can suggest that. You can comment below. So print beam. I've already named it to save the time. So here we have one beam from this column to this column. We have another beam from this column to this column. So I've named it as PB2. And similarly, I have named all those beams. You can name it or you can draw the lines simply on your copy and you can name there so that you can have easy to remember which beam you are exactly working on. So I will go back to our Stat Pro. I will click on PB1. Then I will go to the concrete design here. Just because I have completed my model in Stat Pro, I have my results over here. So let's see what is there on the top. So on the top, we have three numbers of 12 mm bar. In the center, we have three numbers of 10 mm bar. Now, at the corners are our main reinforcement, or you can say the continuous reinforcement, which will have full length in the beam. Like they will start from the column and they will end to the another column. Like if this is our beam and this my two fingers are columns, okay? So the continuous reinforcement are those reinforcements which will start from here and end here. Okay, now let's go back to our structural drawing and see what we have to write. So these were our continuous reinforcement. Now the extra reinforcement. Extra reinforcement are those reinforcement which you can see in our Stat Pro. These, like in this cross section, the four bars at the corners are our continuous reinforcement. And these two are extra reinforcements. So just a minute. Yeah. So the extra reinforcement will act on the top on supports and in the bottom at the center. And there is a different formula, like 0.1L and 0.3L. That's a different thing. I have already discussed it in our previous classes, or I will discuss it in our next class when we will start designing about the beam. Okay. So now how to prepare the chart. So I've already made an Excel sheet for you. I've copied the Excel sheet from the structural drawing that you can see here. So this was our structural drawing. I've just copied that in our Excel sheet. So I've made plinth beam. This plinth beam marked, once we will write all the specifications about all the plinth beams, we can select them and categorize them as PB1, PB2, PB3, PB4, and again here PB1. Okay. Now, so for PB1, I have made a table. Let me show it to you. Yeah, this drawing over here. So for PB1, here is 3 numbers of 12 mm bar. Now, in the continuous reinforcement, how much 12 mm bar do we need? So, continuous reinforcement is the reinforcement at the corners of the cross section. So, we need full length of 12 mm bars over here. So, out of these 3, I will use 2 numbers of 12 mm bar as the continuous one. Okay, so 2 numbers of 12T. This is how we write 2 numbers of 12 mm bar. 12 mm is the diameter of the bar. Okay, at bottom we have 3 numbers of 10 mm dia bar. So we will use 2 number of 10 mm dia bar in the bottom. And what about the third one? Like we have used 2 here. So where is the third one? Because it's showing that we have 3 numbers of 12 mm dia bar at the bottom. So that will be our extra reinforcement. And we will write it here. So for the top, at the start, we have 3 numbers of 12 mm dia bar. So we will write it as 2 12T in the top and 1 12T at the start. In the end, it's 3 number of 12 mm dia bar. So we will distribute it as 2 bars. I have already distributed 2 12T in the top. So we are left with only 1 bar of 12 mm dia. And we will write it here. So now what about the center? So in the center, the extra reinforcement is just at the bottom. So we will choose from the bottom. So we have 3 number of 10 mm dia bar, or we have already used 2 numbers of 10 mm dia bar at the bottom as a continuous reinforcement. So we will use 1 number of 10 mm dia bar at the center. Now the question is about spacing. So spacing of the shear reinforcement at support and center. So here we can see we need 11 number of 8 mm dia bars center to center, and the distance will be 160. Same is here at this support. Now let's have a theory. We have to use 8 mm dia bar as shear reinforcement. Now we have to decide the spacing of our shear reinforcements. So here it is, the stat pro has designed this that spacing should be minimum of 160 mm center to center. So when we go to the practical grounds, we always take center to center distance in a multiple of 25. So what is the nearest multiple of 25 which is less than 160 mm? That's 150. So we will provide shear reinforcement as 8T at the rate 150 center to center, which means we are providing 8 mm dia bar at 150 center to center distance, 150 mm. Now why is there 200 mm center to center distance at our center? So we know shear force is minimum at our center. So we can increase our shear force reinforcement distance or spacing by 25 to 50 mm. So I have increased it to 200 mm. That is, I have increased it by 50 mm. So here it was 8T at the rate 150 center to center, and now at center we have 8T at the rate 200 mm center to center. Now, I have already explained everything here, but let's have a look about our PV tool. Let me maximize it first. So this is our PV tool as per our already specified drawing. We have mentioned the name as PV tool. Here you can see this beam was named as PB2 because this is a plinth beam, so it's PB. Now I will go back to our stat, so it's PB2. We will click on it and open PB2. We will go to the concrete design. See friends, we definitely need to design in Stat Pro or any other designing softwares like Tekla Structural Designer. Tekla Structural Designer is way easier than Stat Pro. If you will compare my classes of Stat Pro, and I will also make classes on Tekla Structural Designer. I have also made one, but you can see that, you can check that over here. So you can differentiate between Stat Pro and Tekla Structural Designer, but for now we will come back to our Tekla. So here our Tekla has already designed our model, and now we will learn how to use this information in this drawing. So our plinth beam was PB2, our size, we have already assigned the same size to all our plinth beams, so it's 250 by 250. Now, what is the reinforcement over here? So we can see that here we have provided 5 numbers of 10 mm dia bar. So you can write it as 2 10 t, because in the top we can just provide 2 continuous bars, and in the bottom it's 3 number of 12 mm dia bar, so we will also use 2 12 t. Now what about the start and end of the extra reinforcement? So it's 2 is already used here, so what we have left at the start, so it was 5 number of 10 mm dia bar, we have used 2 over here, so we are left with 3 number of 10 t, and even at the end we have the same numbers like 5 10 t, so we will just use it as 3 10 t. What about the center? So at center, the extra reinforcement in the center is always provided at the bottom of the beam. So we will check for the bottom. We have used 2 continuous bar of 12 mm dia over here. So we are left with just 1, because 1 bar of 12 mm dia. And if you add this and this, you can get that we have now 3 numbers of 12 mm dia bar in the bottom, and if you add this and this, then you can get we have now 5 numbers of 10 mm dia bar. Okay, so this is how we prepare this. Now what about the spacing? So here we can see we need a spacing of 160 mm here, and the bar should be of size 8T. So it is similar to our the previous bar, so we can just copy it, and even at the center we can increase the spacing by 50 mm, so we will just copy it again. So this is how we prepare our drawing for plinth beam. I hope you will understood it, and I will, in the upcoming class, I will discuss how to classify these beams and make our structural drawing like this, like how we have used just PBM1, PB2, PB3 and PB4 over here, and how I will also show you how to make this plinth beam layout. Okay, this plinth beam layout is drawn in AutoCAD, so I will show you that too. But before that, all I need to do is to first complete this table, prepare the schedule like this one, and only then we can move to the plinth beam layout, which is this one. And now, what is your homework? So you have to tell me in the comment section, what are the usage of a structural drawing? Why all this structural drawing is made? Like, obviously, if you are preparing this structural drawing, then there must be some use of it. So you have to tell me why we make this structural drawing. Okay, so just comment below, and for more lessons, you can stay tuned to our channel. Thank you and bye.